The Yellowstone landscape remains one of my absolute favorite places on the planet. I've been studying the forests in Yellowstone for 35 years. Yellowstone is so well known, it's the world's first national park. It's a good place to both help people appreciate the magnitude of climate change and the potential changes that we'll see in a landscape, and to do so in a place that people they love. But Yellowstone will change, and it's changing at a faster rate than perhaps we had anticipated.
Forests are the backbone of the Greater Yellowstone ecosystem. Large fires are natural in this landscape. For the past 10,000 years, fires have burned through at every 100 to 300 year intervals. Lightning ignites the fires every year, but they only really take off when the summers are really hot and dry and windy. And in fact, historically, most summers have been too cool and too wet for fires to burn. In these forests, fire kills the trees, but it renews the forest. The lodgepole pines, which dominate Yellowstone, have evolved to regenerate really quickly after fire, and even the native grasses and the wild flowers, the native species, they all come back right after fires. And historically, the forest would mature before it has a chance to burn again. But now, human-driven climate change is pushing these forests into uncharted territory. The warming climate is causing more of the hot, dry summers that allow big fires to burn. And in addition, the fire season is getting longer. Summer weather like we had in 1988, when the big Yellowstone fires burned nearly a third of Yellowstone National Park, that kind of weather could become the norm rather than the exception. The interval between fires could get as low as 30 years or shorter by the end of the century. It takes these forests almost 100 years to recover from a previous fire. So if the fires return before the burned forests recover, they may not even have produced enough seeds to be able to regenerate a forest again. And even if the seeds are available, the soils could be too hot and too dry for the tree seedlings to germinate and establish. We're already starting to see some of the changes that happen when the forests aren't recovering the same way that they've done throughout the past. In some areas, fires have burned in as short as 16 or 28 years, so less than that 30-year interval that I mentioned. The post-fire tree seedlings, they're also having a hard time establishing in areas where the soils are too hot and too dry. And then in some areas, trees haven't recovered even after 15 years have passed since a wildfire, because they don't have a seed supply, and also the conditions are just too hot and too dry.
Hey, bear.
The forests are really struggling now to establish and survive. The climate seems to us to be changing at a faster rate than the tree species are even able to adapt and keep up. But what does that mean for the future of this landscape? How is this iconic area going to change as the 21st century unfolds? So obviously we can't collect data from a landscape that doesn't exist yet, but we also can't wait 40 or 50 more years to see what will happen. Instead, we use computer models which build on our years of past data to explore how the future may unfold, specifically to understand how the carbon emissions that are changing the atmosphere will affect the climate and the fire and the future of the Yellowstone landscape. That gives us an idea of how and where the landscape will change.
According to our models, the vast forests that we know and love in Yellowstone may be greatly reduced in the next 50 to 100 years. Some areas may transition actually away from forests and into sagebrush or grassland or meadow. That would mean less trees to provide shade on trails and along rivers for hiking and fishing. The animal species who rely on older forests will have less habitat and fewer of the resources they need to survive. The overall aesthetic of the parks will change as the majestic old-growth forests disappear, and the forests that do remain will be young and sparse and patchy. So people's overall experience in this landscape is going to change a lot. And that is, unless we do something now to lessen the magnitude and slow the rate of climate change.
One of my doctoral students, Timon Keller, is using photographs that we can change based on the results of our computer simulation models and translating those into pictures of landscapes that people see as they visit the Tetons and Yellowstone and the surrounding lands.
We show people a photo of a current landscape and then a photo of the same landscape as the model predicts it could look if carbon emissions continue to increase, leading to hot, dry weather and a lot more fire. Then we show them how that same landscape could look if carbon concentrations in the atmosphere are stabilized so they don't rise anymore by mid-century. And then the less warming means fires don't keep growing so much and more forests will be able to persist. To gauge people's preferences and understanding, we also ask for their reactions to see if these photos help them see how climate change will alter this landscape in the future.
We've thought a lot about how we can communicate this work effectively and make sure that the results of the models that we produce are intuitive and easy for people to understand as they're passing by. And that's where those pictures come in.
It is really hard for people to visualize a landscape that they haven't seen yet and to get people to understand the urgency of how things may change. So we hope that by depicting that, we'll help them understand really what changes are likely to happen in the future.
This is just such a cool reminder that the science that we do matters for people. We want to engage people in that process and share what we find to make people's lives better. And I think that really is something very special about this opportunity.
I know that places like Yellowstone are going to still be beautiful. There's still going to be places that inspire us. We know so many changes are coming. They're not going to be the same as they were.
But I have hope in the next generation of scientists and in our younger citizens. Like me, so many of them have been inspired by the Greater Yellowstone Ecosystem, and they really want to work hard to protect it. We can implement policies to restore the atmosphere, slow the rate of change, and protect Yellowstone and so many other natural areas and the resources on which all of us depend. Yellowstone is going to look different in the future, but how different it will become depends on all of us.